Reverend Ian Christie is about to begin. Please turn to page 666.
From the pages of Helden of the Beast, your weekly heavy metal history lesson with Ian Christie.
Hi, it's Ian Christie, and today Roots hails the return of death metal pioneers Possessed. We'll have a refresher course in the early milestones by this Bay Area band, play a few rarities, plus covers by admirers including 1349, Marduk, Amon Amarth, Angel Corpse, Cannibal Corpse, Cavalera Conspiracy, and Death. This is from the brand new one, Revelations of Oblivion, the first recorded signs of hell from Possessed in over 30 years. No more room in hell, and you're listening to Roots on SiriusXM.
To find your brain, cause you had your last breath. We
Yeah, a scorching return to form by the great Bay Area death metal godfathers Possessed here on SiriusXM's one and only metal history lesson, Roots. Very happy to have back in the fold, finally crafted, not rushed at all, ready for the rapture, new Blasphemies by Bay Area forerunners Possessed. This is the band of young teenagers that played the Ruthie's Inn and Stone circuit that launched the careers of Exodus and really Metallica, not to mention Testament, or as they were known then, Legacy, and really out-of-town bands including Slayer and Megadeth. But while you can look at the Bay Area thrash metal scene and see it in waves, really, with Metallica and Exodus at the forefront, followed by Testament and Death Angel, and then Violence, Defiance, Forbidden, Blind Illusion, etc., Possessed's story really stands out and veers in a completely different direction. This is a band that, hot on the heels of Venom's Extremity, Motorhead's completely raw approach to metal, Hellhammer's completely diabolical and demented, hell-torn approach to death, to playing something new called death metal, Possessed was that, and really viewed by the elders in the thrash metal scene as kind of like snotty little satanic kids running around. But the legacy has shown 30 years on that they were anything but that. A truly visionary band that combined not just the metal lessons of Iron Maiden and Judas Priest, but even saw what was coming down the pike with Metallica and Slayer and accelerated it, made it more extreme, turned it into a pure, fanatical, diabolical, blasphemous maelstrom that if you start the clock ticking with their 1984 demo with the songs Evil Warriors, Burning in Hell, Fallen Angel, and Death Metal, they were years ahead of the death metal explosion to come and responsible for influencing everyone involved in American death metal music. Even bands that you could call contemporaries, like Repulsion out of Michigan and definitely Death from Altamont Springs, Florida, are either peers of Possessed or another wave altogether that took the surprisingly technical assault of what Possessed was doing and further refined it into the death metal that we know today. Possessed is maybe a name that's a little bit buried underneath the mud of time. Not among the unholy and totally demented, dedicated death metal fanatics, however, as we'll see and is solidly proven by the quality of bands covering Possessed on today's show. We've got tracks to come by Amon Amarth, Marduk, 1349, Cavalera Conspiracy, Cannibal Corpse, even an instrumental version of a Possessed classic done by Death during the individual thought pattern sessions. We'll kick this off with a maniacal debut by Possessed. Keep in mind that Possessed's debut album, Seven Churches, was released at the end of 1985. This is the same year that Slayer did Hell Awaits, that Exodus released Bonded by Blood, and then here's this band of high schoolers, not even 6 months after those two landmark albums, pushing the barrier and the limits that much farther ahead. Though they came from the Bay Area and played with thrash metal bands all the time, they occupied a complete darker, more subterranean world, similar to bands like Destruction, Sodom, Creator out of Germany, the disbanded Hellhammer from Switzerland, maybe Bathory from Sweden, but so much more technical and brutal, really. The atmosphere just being secondary to the frenzy and satanic fervor of the riffs. So here's their first recorded appearance from early 1985's Metal Massacre 6 album. This is the famed Metal Blade Records compilation series that previously brought us Metallica, Slayer, Voivod, Hellhammer, Rat, Trouble, and so many others. Metal Massacre 6, featuring Possessed, Nasty Savage, Hollow's Eve, Hyrax, Dark Angel, The Obsessed, and a handful of others. Tributes to come by Marduk, Amon Amarth, Death, and 1349. This is the Almighty Possessed, Swing of the Axe. I'm Ian Christie on SiriusXM.
Dead, tossing the earth, blood on the blue. losing lord. If it didn't do the same for the now, I think you must see, hate the within, and will die the exorcist.
We'll be right back.
Yeah, welcome back to Roots. This is your weekly metal history lesson, and today we hail the return of the almighty Possessed. Marduk there covering a later Possessed track called Phantasm. That one written by guitarist Larry Lalonde, who really came into his own later in the band's very short career. I'm Ian Christie. I wrote a book called Sound of the Beast, The Complete Headbanging History of Heavy Metal, and I'm the publisher of Bazillion Points Books, home to big, fat, juicy volumes filled with centuries of metal lore, including Swedish death metal, Metallica and the Slayer Mag Diaries, and Murder in the Front Row, shots from the Bay Area thrash metal epicenter, which indeed features all the original photographs taken for the back cover of Possessed's Seven Churches album. Check it out at bazillionpoints.com. Possessed timeline in the original era, before the regrouping in the 21st century, it's short and sweet. It's a bunch of teenage kids, like sophomores in high school, gathered together in 1983, persisted through several lineup changes before ending up on the resolutely ultra-satanic band that recorded the 1984 demo. They acquired a manager named Debbie Obono, and though they were very young, immediately had offers to release their records, not just from Metal Blade, who did end up being the first to release any Possessed material, that song Swing of the Axe that we heard earlier, but also competitors like Torrid Records or Combat Records, where they ultimately ended up alongside bands like Exodus, Merciful Fate, Megadeth, and much later, Death. Then in 1985 saw the release of their debut album, Seven Churches. And though way after the fact it's become kind of a sport to argue whether Seven Churches or Death's Scream Bloody Gore was the first death metal album, I look at it as the Seven Churches album being like the first Black Sabbath album versus Death offering the first Judas Priest album. There is no reason to pit these two against each other. They're from different eras, separated by 3 years. During a time when metal was accelerating and becoming more extreme basically week by week. For sure, in late 1985, Seven Churches was the rallying cry for the future of death metal. There was no widely available album that competed in terms of speed, satanic fever, and while still having plenty of thrash metal underpinnings, all of the elements that would later become hallmarks of death metal are present in one form or another. The band went at the end of 1985 to Montreal, Quebec, played before 7,000 people alongside Celtic Frost, Destruction, Voivod, and Nasty Savage at the legendary World War III Festival, and began touring internationally. Of course, schedule had to be worked around the fact that the members were still mostly in high school. Some of the songs we're hearing today, like the Marduk and Amon Amarth and Cannibal Corpse covers, come from later albums after Seven Churches, the 1986 album Beyond the Gates, and the 1987 EP Eyes of Horror. These, to me, do represent much more of a thrash metal style, and I think it's simply because there were no guideposts at that time. When they released in 1985 Seven Churches, they were really coming out of the cosmos. They were coming out of their own imaginations with that. And then, at the end of the year, who did they have to look at but Slayer and Exodus? Supremely violent and frequently satanic thrash metal bands that, you know, Possessed was very happy to be under the wings of. So as they grew and professionalized, they did, I would say, veered more into Slayer territory. And maybe that's where a lot of the confusion comes from, people who underestimate the impact on death metal that Possessed has. About midway through 1987, Possessed in its legendary format disbanded, and guitarist Larry Lalonde went on to be in Blind Illusion. Soon after that, he and Blind Illusion bassist Les Claypool made a go of the funk metal band Primus. Meanwhile, the other members regrouped in new bands. However, Jeff Becerra was attacked and shot in 1989 and ever since has been wheelchair bound. It's Becerra who has regrouped in 2019 and, after 10 years of playing shows and touring internationally, recorded the new album Revelations of Oblivion. However, back in the early 1990s, it was another founding member, Mike Toreo, who resurrected the Possessed name with a completely different lineup. Going to play you a demo track from 1993, a song called Last Ritual. No Jeff Becerra or Larry Lalonde in sight. Got a few covers by Angel Corpse, Swedish death metal gods Impious, the great Cannibal Corpse, and then a legendary Possessed song from Seven Churches that pretty much says it all. I'm Ian Christie. This is your weekly metal history lesson, Roots. We are hailing the return of the almighty Possessed today on SiriusXM. We'll be right back.
pages of your heavy metal history lesson.
Bloody Roots.
Liquid metal!
Yeah.
must confess, when she died, she was the best.
There it is. Where does it all begin? With Possessed's death metal, Mantis's death by metal, the European compilation album featuring Hellhammer called Death Metal. I think it's fair to say that Hellhammer cracked open the cosmos, made future death metal and black metal possible. Possessed, though, it is square zero for death metal's evolution. We're fantastically lucky to have a new album by the band in 2019. And I'm sure another death metal godfather, Chuck Schuldiner of Death, would say the same if he were fortunate enough to be here with us. Thanks very much for joining me. Extremely happy to be bringing you, once again, the music of Possessed. Trace the band's history extensively. Jeff Becerra is interviewed in the book Sound of the Beast, the complete headbanging history of heavy metal, and also repeatedly in the book Metallion, the Slayer Mag Diaries. Also, the original Possessed live lineup and Seven Churches photo shoot sessions. Photos by Harold Oyman in the great book Murder in the Front Row, Shots from the Bay Area Thrash Metal Epicenter. Available all at bazillionpoints.com and follow Instagram, etc. at bazillionpoints. Thank you very much. We wrap up this pentagram-studded salute with more 21st century metal by the great Possessed. From Revelations of Oblivion, this is Abandoned. I'm Ian Christie. Thanks, Satan, for putting us all here. Know your roots!
You just heard Ian Christie's Bloody Roots.